Hello, Viking Nation! As you all are watching this show, our beautiful Triton hockey players are gearing up for an epic showdown on the ice this weekend against our arch-rival Newburyport Clippers.
If you've ever been to one of these games, you know how intense they can be, not only on the ice, but also in the stands.
Triton versus Newburyport brings out the angry Viking in all of us, no matter the sport. Leading off today's show, some of our athletes describe, in their own words, what the rivalry means to them.
Triton versus Newburyport.
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 Triton versus Pentucket.
A tale old as time, the hottest rivalry in all of the Cal. In every sport, it's a game that people look forward to. But what does this game really mean to the Triton community?
My name is Liam Nealand.
Lucas Tinkham.
My name is Carlo Lucy.
Ben Chadwick.
Mike Ruzicki.
Michael Welch.
Michael. Big Mike.
So, Kyle.
Cameron.
Pretty easy to beat. They've never been as good as me.
Annoying.
I feel like most of them are pretty tall.
No.
Average height to tall height.
Ew. Bad at sports, even though they
won. Oh, but they're 5-0 against your team, right?
Biggest game of probably my life.
If it's hockey, it's going to be competitive. A lot of hitting. You got to be smart, keep your head up, and not get distracted by the loud crowd.
You know, we were pretty hyped up for the game. I had good expectations going in, but we ended up losing that game 42-0.
So our mentality was a lot different than it was this past season.
Definitely more physical because they were going to come out physical.
Knowing that your opponent is just as motivated as you are to win the game, I think that plays a big role.
We just have more energy. Because we want to win, because nobody likes Newburyport.
The difference that I see is today, we didn't hang out with them.
Sure.
So today I find that there are a lot of kids that know who they're playing against, and they have that connection. So it's very strange because they're kind of friends. It's like, what is that all about? They're Newburyport, we shouldn't be their friends.
I knew some names, not anybody specifically though. So I didn't really have any beef going on the field.
Yeah.
I knew some thugs though. I knew a lot of thugs.
I knew of a kid, but that's all.
And did that change your mentality at all?
No, not at all.
When you know them, you're friends with them on the outside, you may or may not like them, whatever, but once you play, they do click that switch. Definitely in the cheers that I hear, they're derogatory, and I think that they feel like they have a little bit of superiority over us. You know, they're the golden children of the world, right? And they can, you know, I don't like that. I don't like that feeling. That doesn't belong. They are able to have a culture that's different than ours because they all live in the same town and they all hang out together and they can all walk and pick up a game by just walking downtown. They also are much more invested in club sports. Guess what? What do you need to play club sports? We did a sign language off camera, so you don't know what we were talking about.
I think it's good to have a rival, someone to like go out, get pumped, beat. I think it's a great thing to have for a team. And Newburyport, I see as our biggest rival. Whenever I go up against them, I'm angry.
Going into that, I know that there's going to be a lot more meaning behind that than any other game we play during a normal season.
I mean, it means everything to me. It's huge.
Yeah.
It's huge to everyone in the school, probably.
They're more like, oh, this is Triton. We're going to stomp on them like we always do. Like what happened in basketball 2 weeks ago. Even though we played Pentucket for the Thanksgiving game, I still think Port's a bigger rival.
Their parents are worse than they are.
Really?
Yeah, their parents at the last game were chirping us more than the players were.
I would say watch out this upcoming track season. I know you beat us yesterday, but this spring, we're coming for you, okay? It's no doubt.
You're coming hard and fast for all your teams. Prepare your players.
You're not that good, and we're going to win next time we play you.
I think by senior year, we're going to beat Newburyport in football.
When do we play them? Then we're going to kick their butts the 27th, and we're going to break their streak and come out with the dub.
That got me pumped for the game tomorrow.
The puck drops at noon at the Graff Rink. Come out and get loud.
Tomorrow's game is anything like the past games against Port. Our athletic trainer, Mike Rizicki, is going to be a busy man.
Mike is great at what he does, and all the athletes love him. Bella and Molly followed him for a couple days to learn what his job is really like.
I've been feeling a little bit better.
My name is Mike Rizicki. I'm the head athletic trainer here at Triton High School. I graduated from Bridgewater State University in 2012 with my bachelor's degree in athletic training. And then after a delay, I went to my master's degree at Texas State University for athletic training for 2017. And now I'm here. I pretty much found athletic training by chance. When I was in college, I was looking for careers that would keep me involved with sports. Also growing up, I've been an athlete my entire life and I was always getting hurt. So I wanted to learn more about injuries, the workings behind it. I was interested in the human body. So when I found athletic training at Bridgewater, it was a perfect fit for me. Some pros is, you know, you work with some great people, you get to help others, help people through some of their worst times as an athlete potentially. And it's very rewarding work. But some of the cons is the hours are very atypical, and that also includes weekends and holidays. So I come into school at around 1:30, and then I leave school at around 5, 6, 7, 8, or 9, depending on the day and what practices and games are going on. I'll do some documentation. I'll document all the injuries and the treatments I did the day prior at home. And when it comes to the actual day's events, if it's game days, that means I'm getting waters ready, water and ice. I'm taking care of treatments from the kids coming in from the day before, getting them ready for practice or games. And then I'd also do some game and practice coverage.
My name is Peyton.
My name is Braden Lopes.
My name is Aubrey Jotes.
During the fall, I go see Mike every day and he tapes my thumb.
I go almost every day, mostly for rehab for my knee.
During volleyball season, I went to see him almost every time before practice to both fill up my water and get my ankle wrapped.
So I have students come in from Salem State University and Endicott College, and those students are fulfilling their clinical requirements for athletic training. So when they're in athletic training program, as a student, you need to get 200 hours or so of clinical experience. It's an opportunity for you to practice the skills that you learn in class under supervision. I love being a preceptor. I get to teach the students some of the knowledge and experience I've accrued over the years, but I also learn things from them as well. The most common injury by far is ankle sprains. That's something that we see extremely common, not just here, but everywhere. I would say as far as the best pieces of advice I can give to students is to stay active throughout the year. That's gonna help keep muscles strong, keep coordination up, as well as doing some of the very basic things, getting plenty of great high quality sleep, eating well, and doing some type of strength training as well. That's gonna strengthen the muscles, the bones, the ligaments, and all that, and it's gonna decrease injury drastically.
Last year I had an incident with stunting and I broke my foot and I went down to him as soon as it happened and he wrapped it up and he put ice on it and he helped me.
I had a bad injury that happened during football season, which Mike has greatly helped me through.
So the sign-in sheet that we have is there to keep track of how many kids we're seeing, how often we're doing certain treatments like taping, rehab, what types of injuries are coming in. And ideally, we get to pull all that data and identify trends. So if we're seeing a sudden increase in one injury, is there a specific reason as to why that might be? And can we take some preventative measures to decrease that from coming in? So it's very helpful for us at the school and at the hospital group to see what the numbers are like. And it also is important for documentation and tracking purposes.
It's important to have a good athletic trainer because you want to make sure you're safe if you get hurt.
I think it's important because he can really give you good diagnosis and tell you when you need to go to a doctor and when you don't. Because sometimes if you go to a doctor, they take you out unnecessarily and then you don't get to play the sport that you really love.
I think it's important to have a good athletic trainer because he keeps the kids healthy and having a good community, and he's always just so fun to be around, to go down there before your games and your practices, and I just overall think it's a really important part of school.
Mike's awesome.
Agreed.
And speaking of awesome, we live in such an awesome place between the beaches and the mountains. We couldn't live in a more beautiful location.
One of the best ways of enjoying the scenery on the North Shore is by taking a long, slow bike ride down one of our beautiful rail trails with the wind blowing through your hair. You can smell the raw sewage coming off the Merrimack. I can picture it now.
Noah Alcaraz did just that earlier this fall, and he put together this next montage.
That was so cool. I've always wanted to ride the rail trail.
So why haven't you?
I don't know. It takes a lot of effort to get the bike and the car and then drive to the trail, and it takes a while to ride. I just keep putting it off. Maybe someday, though.
So you're a procrastinator.
Really bad.
Cam, I think it's time we make it official.
Pin, it's only been a year. What's the rush?
Cam, we've been dating for 5 years. I think it's time we move in together.
Payton, I'm up for a promotion soon. We could get a much better place. Let's just wait.
Cam, we've been together for 10 years now. When are you going to propose?
We've come this far. Why don't wait a little longer? Payton, 15 years ago, when we made it official on this exact field, I knew you were the one for me. Will you marry me?
Cam, you've waited too long. I've already found my true love.
Let's go, Pookie.
Thank you.
2.5 hours from Triton's front door is Lock Mountain in Maine, where the Sunday River Ski Resort is located.
Many Triton students head to Sunday River during the winter for some epic skiing. A few weeks ago, Carl brought Everett to the mountain for one of Everett's first skiing experiences. Here's how it went.
What's up, guys? It's Carl.
Everett.
We're on our way to the mountain right now. We're going to be skiing at Sunday River. Everett, how are you feeling?
Great.
You ever skied before?
Like twice.
Twice in your life?
Yeah.
So, what are your expectations today? What do you think you're going to be able to do?
Everything.
You got any goals for today?
360 off a jump.
So you're going for a 360 today? Yep. You hear that, guys? 360. Any backflip today?
Yeah, probably a double.
Double backflip.
Maybe a triple.
All right, I'm excited to film it. Let's go get it.
See you after.
Thank you.
And who is the ticket for?
Me. Oh, wait, so Everett Romano.
Everett's first time on a chairlift?
Not my first time.
First time in 3 years?
Say my first roadie.
Keep doing that every you want to be all set. Like, don't lift your legs, use your heels.
Oh, he did it! He did it!
Dude, I nailed it!
I'm a gorilla in a
over is a blue.
This is so easy.
I'm gonna die.
You have it.
I'm just gonna sit, like stay sitting and ride it back down the chairlift.
You're just not gonna get off the chairlift? You.
He's got it.
Dude, look at this.
Sounds icy.
Everything's getting icy. Come on, gonna pull up to the zoo. So, who the f is you? I don't know. No, pull up on your blocks. We gon' blow. Run for the pole. Hey, please. Gas what I smoke. Fast in my dough, jump out the window. No, you can't get no money, silly. Silly. I just hit the stain.
Yeah, dude, doing great.
Funny dough, funny dough. Hey, funny dope. Hey. Talking out his neck, pistol to his throat, bang, blow this cause he gon' choke.
Everett!
On the ground, on the floor, someone pick him up, take him to the mall, to the fucking thing.
Day two, new man.
You gonna conquer that today?
Finna go and shoot New Jersey up. Tryna take my chain, I ain't going. We gon' come in Jersey up. You want some? Hurry up. Try to rob me 30 up. Just my volcano carried up.
My favorite part of that video was watching Everett getting a ride down the mountain from Ski Patrol.
Me too. Hey. I got a question. Do you think that these two are siblings or dating?
That's a hard one. Dating.
Common misconception. That's actually twin brothers Jonathan and William Height.
Well, next up you guys get to take the siblings or dating challenge. Do you think you could tell the difference?
100%!
There are many different types of couples nowadays, but today, we went around and asked Triton students and faculty whether or not these two were siblings or dating.
Roll the clip. Are these siblings or dating?
I would say siblings and dating. Probably dating.
Ding, ding, ding. Are these siblings or are they
dating? They look alike. Say dating.
Are these siblings or are they dating?
They're siblings.
Wrong. Are these siblings or are they dating?
Siblings.
Are these siblings or are they dating?
Siblings.
Are these siblings or are they dating?
Looks like similar, so I would say they're siblings. Yeah, I feel like it would look weird in public seeing those two together, you know?
So I'll give you that. Are these siblings or are they dating?
Siblings.
Are these siblings or are they dating?
I think they're siblings.
Right. Are these siblings or are they dating?
They look like siblings.
Are they dating or are they siblings?
They're siblings.
Are they siblings or are they dating?
Siblings.
Are they siblings or are they dating?
Siblings.
Correct. Okay. Are they siblings or are they dating?
Definitely siblings.
Wrong. Are they siblings or are they dating?
They're siblings.
Wrong. Siblings or are they dating?
Siblings.
Are they siblings or are they dating?
Siblings.
Those are some interesting and bad answers. Thank you for watching. I'm London from VTV.
And I'm Audrina.
Thanks for watching this episode of VTV. You guys are the best.
We'll catch you on the flip side. I'm Cameron Michael Neary.
And I'm Andrew Douglas Falloon. Let's do it.
Hello, Viking Nation! Mike is great at what he does, and all of the athletes love him. Did he write this?
All right, practice?
Nope.
No practice.
One and done. Yep. Right, here we go. Quiet in the room.
Watch
we'll
this. It's never been done, guys.
Mike Rizik. Can I just say Mike? And speaking of awesome, we live in such an awesome place between the beaches and the mountains. We couldn't live in a more beautiful location. We're very lucky.
I'm going to improv a little bit. One of the many ways of enjoying the beautiful scenery on the North Shore is by taking a long, slow bike ride down one of our rail trails, with the wind blowing through your hair, the sun setting over the Merrimack.
Let's do it.
Shh. It's the caw of a seagull getting food poisoning from the clams off Salisbury Beach.
Well, next up, you guys get to take the siblings or dating challenge. Do you think you could tell the difference?
100%!